the wind and the cold when you get high, and you're there with birds in the air. And
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The launch window is open. The launch window is open.
Cloudline Road on Marshall Mountain, just northeast of San Bernardino. Every one of the over 400 races in this year's National Hang Gliding Championships begins right here for several very good reasons. First, the thermals, or rising currents of warm air. Ocean breezes, heated as they cross our inland valley, stack up here in Devil's Canyon and must escape by rising and displacing cooler air. They are the same air currents that create these giant cumulus clouds so common to this area.
This is the mecca for hang gliding pilots. We've had people from all over the world. They got to come and fly Crestline before they die.
Then there's the pilots. The greatest concentration of the best in the world live right here in Southern California.
Some of these fellows are so sensitive to it, some of them can smell thermals, and you get so you can see shears.
And then there's Andy Jackson, a positive, playful bundle of energy who moved his family from a two-story San Bernardino house, complete with three-car garage and pool, to this mobile home on 10 acres of semi-desert, so that he could create Pinecrest Air Park for hang gliding. Andy went for it and managed to bring the National Hang Gliding Championships into his own backyard.
About 3 years ago, I got the idea that if I could build a permanent hang glider park, or airport as it were, for hang gliders, it would be a kind of a neat way to make a living. You know, if you can make a living at doing something you really love, that's the only way to go.
The event is a full 10 days long. Perhaps the competition is best appreciated if seen from the air. After taking off 2,000 feet above the valley floor, pairs of hang gliders must race several laps around two pylons, both higher than the takeoff point. Therefore, they must find the thermals and circle and climb with them to complete the course.
If you've ever seen hawks just circling, gaining altitude, we do basically the same thing. And we're not quite on their level yet, but we're getting there.
Out of competition, some hang glider pilots have climbed to 16,000 feet for sustained flights of over 100 miles, riding the Devil's Canyon thermals. Each race ends here with a landing on the strip at Andy's airpark.
I won 11 and lost one, and I didn't have to fly the last round because I was far enough ahead. Usually I probably averaged about an hour and 15 minutes a race. Some were longer, some were shorter.
At the end of the competition, some of the pilots put on a show for themselves, their families, and friends. Why are these three guys smiling? Because they just finished doing this.
I just might fly away. Oh, I might fly away and go my own way. Places that we've never been together.
That roaring you hear is the wind racing over the hang glider's wings. So, the competition was a great success. But Andy's air park is still incomplete. He envisions landscaped areas, camping facilities, and a pool and spa for his hang gliding friends. But another obstacle stands in the way of all of that, one we haven't told you about. Andy Jackson has been diagnosed as having a terminal disease.
I didn't discover that I had cancer until last January. And this dream here I've been working on for, you know, three years. My fear now is that I'm not going to get it done before, you know, something happens drastic. Although, with the good Lord's help, I'm going to lick it, you know. I'm going to live forever. The doctors, you know, they tell me different, but they don't know a whole hell of a lot anyway. When you hang glide, you're the only person in the world, and the next flight is going to be your best one. You got to get back up and do it again. There's just no way you can wait to get back up and fly again.
Flying away.
It may not be the safest sport, but it is.